Hello, it's Jang here with a look at the McFarlane AMC The Walking Dead prison series of sets, Wave 2. In the first season, we got the Watchtower, and now we've got all these interior bits. So let's look at these one by one. First up, here's the prison catwalk set, which comes with 368 pieces. This kind of defines the structure for the major inner cell block section of the prison. It includes a staircase going up to the upper level on one side and a staircase on the other. This is kind of the back side of it here. I had a little bit of trouble just finding all the right parts to make the correct kind of striation. There are slight differences between the colors that they use for some different weathered pieces, and I don't think this worked out quite entirely as expected, but you can see that the type of weathering that they use has variance to it, because it's done just randomly with this really heavy wash over some of the pieces and makes the whole thing look very old and run down. This is actually pretty nice right here, what they've done with the frosted glass section, which actually has semi-transparent or translucent material that's used for it, so it lets some light through. Has a different texture on the other side. It's actually very, very realistic. There's a lot of realism to this, especially with just how much texture they really add with the paint applications, and especially with the washes and the dry brushing type of techniques. This upper floor, interestingly, actually has four little sections that you can pull out. So if you want to show that the upper floor has begun to collapse, you can actually take these out, and it just leaves a little bit of rebar behind there. Here's the main sliding door into the block, and this is able to actually slide open, so you can pose that either way that you like. Each of these cells, well, there are two cells included here, one up top, one down below. Each of them has a door which can be just hinged open, and those also have a nice amount of wash on them each. These are just little pins sticking out if you want to expand the cell block by adding on additional cell sets. Each individual cell has a little sink in there, a little toilet, and then a table, and also a bed, which you can use. Yes, it is very dark in there. There's a bed which you can set up with a couple of different options. If you look down at the lower floor, you see there's a different type of tattered old blanket that's over that, and there's a pair of pillows included in total. And each table gives you options for different things that you can place on there. So these are just some of the defaults that are suggested, but here are some other options for different things that you can place onto those same tables. And these are included with this one set as well. This prison catwalk set comes with good old Herschel, who has a great face, really well molded, and just captures his look quite well with only the single paint application for the hair, and then just a general wash over the whole thing. And then the walker is crouching and eating a little bit there. So a croucher, not a walker then. Also a pretty good looking one, and a different kind of pose from most of the ones that they've included in the series or that they've produced. I was not able to get Herschel's head all the way down onto the neck little pin that sticks out there. The slight manufacturing tolerances can sometimes be an issue with these. I did trim it down just a little bit. Still didn't fit in, needs a little bit more, just a little bit of custom work to kind of to finish that off. Some of them will come through and be in perfect condition and just work fine the first time, but because these parts are so small and so thin and so fine, you will find that just small little differences and quality control issues can kind of multiply. Here's the lower prison cell set, which comes with 96 pieces. If this looks very familiar, well, it should. It's designed exactly like the lower cell on the big catwalk set, and once again, you get the same basic accoutrement on the inside with the toilet, the sink, and a bed, and also a table with an accessory. Once again, they do actually give you a little bit more possibility for customization, changing things out with this one for the number of pieces that you get, because you get another different blanket piece that can be placed over that bed. And once again, they also do include a few other just different little accessories, and these are similar ones that we saw just a minute ago, including a lantern that's added in here. Otherwise, everything that you're going to see here is the same. You know, you notice they do give you a top for this, so you can use it even though it's just intended to be a lower cell. They give the roof over the top. So this can be used as a diorama just by itself. You know, you can set up just a small thing. So I think it works just fine as a standalone set. This particular one here came with Carl, and he doesn't have any weapon or anything. He's just got the hold off kind of stance. The sculpting is once again very good. I think that the wash actually worked out pretty well with this one. It got some of the eye detail in there that some of them don't get, especially when they don't have a wash on them. So this one's actually done pretty well. However, there is an option with this set, and they show you in the window on the package that you can either get Carl or a Riot Gear walker. And you'll be able to see just by looking through the window there which one you're going to get. So you can actually choose in the store whether you want to get this or you want to get Carl. So you don't have to get multiples of Carl if you want to get lots of the Riot Gear ones to build up your whole, you know, your whole prison block with lots of those, then you can. Now here's the upper cell set, which comes with 109 pieces. The cell section itself, again, looks very familiar, and they do give you the two different options for the type of bedding to place in there, and they also give you just one extra accessory as an option to use on the table. This one includes a little bit of structure underneath, and it also has the additional fence, you know, the additional railing and kind of fenced off area off to one side to continue the catwalk around, you know, in the opposite direction of or perpendicular to the way it's done on the actual main catwalk set. And eventually, as you add these out, they will form a full row. Again, you get the top that has the roof on it, and it's actually made with the exact same piece. This one does include one figure, but always the same figure. This set always comes with that particular walker there, so no other different options here. Another pretty well done one. You can see just a little bit of gap on one leg that didn't go in quite all the way. Just needs a little bit of work, just a little shaving down to make that work better. But all of these figures, when they get a full wash, or in this case, it has a couple of applications of thin paint on there, really works out really well. The level of realism is good. And you can see that the foot is able to just hold on to one of those stud pieces on the top that sticks out anywhere that you see those around here. Last up, this is the boiler room set, which comes with 176 pieces and includes two figures, one walker and one standing Rick. This one has the most color, probably the most detail, has the most interesting build with different types of build techniques that are used throughout. Things get attached in different ways. A lot of unique pieces that were made specifically for this set. You see the walker is laying back there and reaching out. Looks really good, very, very creepy. And this has lots of good printed or painted details on there on the individual pieces as well. You actually put together a lot of the whole piping system, which is a pretty satisfying build experience as those things clip together and snap together and you just kind of build it all out. It just feels good, you know, assembling all that together and when it all comes together just right, it's a nice feeling. I had a little bit of issue just lining up the individual small kind of broken concrete pieces. Not every one of those looked exactly the way that they appear in the instructions, and you see this right here came out a different color from the others, and I wasn't able to quite rectify that and, you know, find a proper substitution, but it actually looks okay. But you do see that, so, you know, because these pieces are done randomly and taken from a big bin that are taken at different times, they're not always going to match up with the exact amount of wash that's applied, and the ones that have a little bit more texture will get a little bit more wash kind of settling into them. So if you really want a fully finished, you know, presentation quality finish, you will need to do a little bit of touch up if you're into that kind of thing. There's also one piece that was off in this set. I went through the instructions so many times, but was not able to find the proper piece to fit there. Fortunately, there was one extra. I think that was just a little packaging mistake. So again, just little bits of quality things that are off from time to time that are, you know, you kind of have to weigh that against just how much realism is provided with the McFarlane sets, with all of their, you know, specialized molds and also all the paint applications. This version of Rick doesn't happen to look quite so good in the face. It did kind of bring out face details, but I feel like this one has just a little bit too much of the paint that actually settled in, especially around the sides of the bridge of the nose. It kind of changes his expression from what you normally see of him. Sorry about the focus there, and a little bit tough to get that to stay. There we go. But of course, he has his revolver, and he's just in a very, you know, kind of a deciding pose, deciding what he's gonna do next. And you're not really able to make this one change up to look like he's walking. Stacking the lower and upper cell units is really easy because they don't have a full row of studs going up here, just a handful of them. So it makes taking this whole piece off, and then you can use that for just additional terrain somewhere. It's a really good looking piece. Just go ahead and bring in the upper cell, carefully align it, and just push it right down onto the studs. And there you go. That's how those stack up. And then you can do units like this of a pair, and then just continue adding those on so you can make an entire cell block. Now, connecting together the catwalk and additional cells gets a little bit tricky, just getting that lined up properly. There it goes. Now, there are some unexpected color discrepancies between the catwalk set and the individual cell sets. So right from the start, the doors, you can see, are actually different colors. They have different base colors, I believe, for the plastic pieces. But the washes that were used are definitely clearly different, with the more orangish color and more saturated. I think it's supposed to look a little bit more rusted with the original, the base large catwalk set, but they just don't match. Of course, if you continue to get more of the individual cell sets, they should all match, but it's strange. I think they may have actually made a production update at some point. I have not seen multiples of these to see if they were consistent with the coloring, but that is an unexpected and really unwanted little bit of difference there. There's also a difference in the coloring that they used for all the wash and major weathering for the large top exposed to concrete bits, including the whole walkway up here and also the roof pieces. So this roof piece here is more reddish. Again, just everything going a little bit more to the red side. Now, fortunately, you did see that I had that extra piece, that extra floor or roof piece that came from the lower cell in this case. So I could just swap that on. And interestingly, there's actually a little bit of gap. There's a difference in height between the, you know, the where these end up. So you would either want to leave out a level here, which I don't really recommend, but it's probably better just to add this on top to get more consistency and have it just be smooth and go all the way across. And then you just have the doors. And you could probably just remove at least one of those doors to make it look a little bit better. But it is unfortunate that those color differences exist. But you can see how this is going to start to build out as you get more of the individual cell sets. So that would just continue on and would give you a nice continuous flow of the floor plan and everything, and would look quite good altogether. Now, the boiler room set itself doesn't really fit into this because it's from a different area of the prison. So, you know, you could place it wherever you want to in creating more of a larger display. Is it supposed to be back this way or something? It's a different different building, I think. You know, it's not really going to fit in so well with all of this, but just wanted to bring that into frame. But I do want to show you a little bit more. This, you see, this is what the product series is really all about, is bringing it all together. Yes, you can make some nice small little dioramas for fans, you know, of the show who want to use a small amount of space, but really it's when you start to bring together multiple sets and, you know, add in some of the grab bag, blind bag, mystery pack figures that you can get, especially the walker packs and such. And just, you know, obviously I have just a white background here in the studio, but if you set this up with even just some green felt or even just a wooden background, or, you know, put in just a little bit of detail in the background really starts to bring the whole series alive. And it's the level of detail and the paint applications, especially with the washes, that really set this whole series out and really give it its quality, its high quality. You know, it's the little stuff and the extra care that's put into not just putting a bunch of plastic pieces together. Again, there were quality control issues and, you know, small differences that can be a pain from time to time. But overall, I did want to just share what all of the prison stuff looks like together, because I found it to be really interesting and it's kind of inspiring. You know, if I had the space, it would be really cool to set up a proper set with this, you know, proper setting and a proper large diorama. But it does get quite expensive if you want to start building out your whole cell block back there, getting each, you know, upper cell set and lower cell set. Probably would be nice to end up with a couple of catwalks and such. Plus, they don't have other sets in the series that are just for adding walls, just for adding blocks in general. You can use parts from other manufacturers, you know, and it's compatible with regular brick-based stuff, but nobody else does what McFarlane does with their unique colors and all of their paint applications and such. Let me know what you think about this series. You know, I wanted to focus mostly on just getting the reviews done of these few sets over here for this one to finish up the prison theme, at least for now, or at least through Wave 2. I already reviewed the tower set when that first came out a season ago. But yeah, let me know if you have any thoughts about these individual sets that I just reviewed and about the series on the whole. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.